Welcome.
Picture. Fellow patriot.
Yeah, but we get the hug. Welcome to Arkansas.
Hey, how y'all doing?
You betcha. Welcome.
What'd you do now?
Push that?
Yep.
Okay. Don't hold it again.
Come here.
One. Yes! Welcome to Arkansas.
Welcome, we're glad to have you here.
No.
Welcome to Russellville.
Gotta have a queen of the parade, don't we?
Welcome. Thank you.
Hope
you had a good trip
here.
Hey, everybody.
Thing ever. shockingly to me, kind of transitioning to being a veteran is hard, and I didn't think so because I was a cook before the Navy. I was a cook in the Navy, a good one, not a bad one. And I was a cook after the Navy, so I was thinking this transition won't be hard at all. But transitioning, I kind of like lost my purpose. I didn't know where I fit in. And then some of y'all might know Sunshine. She tagged me in a post for Miss Veteran America. And I thought that would be really cool. You know, I would meet a bunch of veterans. We could do cool things, wear pretty dresses, tiara. So I competed and I found out it's way more than a beauty pageant or something like that. It is to raise money for homeless women veterans. And at first I was a little hesitant because I want to help all homeless veterans, not just women, you know? But I learned statistics about it and it really is a real need right now. So I got a lot of support from y'all actually, and I raised $32,000. In about 7 months for homeless women veterans. And I just want to take this time to thank y'all that supported me, that sent in, you know, any donations, that even liked a post or shared a post, because it helps spread awareness. And I'm just looking forward. I'm going to follow y'all to Forest City, and then I'm going to fly into D.C. and finish the run with y'all. So I'm looking forward to that and really seeing what Run for the Wall is all about, because it's just an amazing thing that y'all have going. And I want to thank y'all for letting me be a part of it.
I would like to thank everyone involved in this welcome. What a fantastic welcome. What'd you say, Run for the Wall? I can't wait to get my turn at the chicken because it smells great. It smells great. So, at this time, we have some certificates of appreciation we would like to hand out.
And we have our local government here. And I wanted to be sure to recognize them. I see we've got our County Judge Ben Cross right here. Waving his hand right there, he is our mayor.
Is there someone representing Veterans Coalition? In grateful appreciation for your generous support for Run for the Wall, Midway Run, we'd like to give you this certificate. Thank you so much. Tom Hughes, from VFW Post 2283. Thank you so much for your support. Absolutely. Mr. Bill Eaton, River Valley Chapter, MOAA. With grateful appreciation, thank you. Dick Thomas, Riggs Hamilton American Legion, Post 20. With grateful appreciation of your support, thank you. Surrett, Dave Turner Chapter, DAV Simpson, Turner Chapter 27. With grateful appreciation. Thank you. Bill Heffley, Marine Corps Lead 1310. Thank you. Patty Taylor. Okay. Cherokee Outreach. Thank you so much. Is there a representative from Russellville Police Department?
It's hard to get all these motorcycles across the country without the help, and I thank you so much for it.
We have a certificate of appreciation and great support for all that you do for us. Thank you. Seville Fire Department, how nice was that? The flags and everything they had for us. Jim Davis, Cherokee Outreach. Thank you so much for your support.
Woo, Dad!
Hey, Dad!
Thank you. And anyone from Russellville Fire Department? Anyone? Thank you. Thank you again. You know, this is a new stop for us. We've never been here before. What a beautiful park. Yeah. I'd like to take this time to thank everyone who cooked,
and prepared for us. The welcome that we got was just amazing. I'd like to thank Christina, our Arkansas State Coordinator, for all the work she did in putting this thing together. And Run for the Wall family, what do we tell these people? Thank you for the support. Thank you.
It's Memorial Park. I want to say first and foremost, welcome to the River Valley. Some of you may have seen the panels on the walls here in our pavilion. This park was started in 2015. And that's when the ground was broken here. The five organizations that are federally chartered, are the ones that make up this Veterans Coalition that have made this park possible. It was a labor of love, and we hope that you have enjoyed it. Everything that has occurred in the time that this park was being built has occurred on certain days that are specific to veterans in our country. There's a small World War I centennial tree that was planted over here, and it was planted on November the 11th, 2017, commemorating the end of World War I, which of course was at the end of 2018. But there's soil from the Meuse-Argonne Cemetery that cradle the roots in this park for that tree. The Pope County Civil War marker, which is to my left, back up by one of the walks, was placed on the date April 12th, 2018, commemorating the anniversary of the attack on Fort Sumter. The first flag raised when our flagpole was installed was raised on June 14th, 2019, the anniversary of the establishment of the United States Army. Gold Star Day, the last Monday in September, was dedicated here by the hanging of the Gold Star stained glass at the south end of our pavilion here. And that date was September 26th, 2019. Our park was dedicated as a Purple Heart Park on December 7th, 2020, Pearl Harbor Day. So those are the kinds of things that we have strived to commemorate as we created this park for veterans and to honor them and their families. So thanks to each one of you for your service to our country. Be careful. Have a safe ride. We thank you so much.
This is our own Gold Star family, Debbie Bowen. She's been a friend of mine for years. And Martin Bowen, their son, David Wyatt, was one of the Marines that was killed in Chattanooga. David Wyatt was my first Patriot Guard mission. And everything David Wyatt in this town, I'm there. And that's how we got to be such good friends, because David Wyatt became my person. Debbie put this together. Staff Sergeant David A. Wyatt, hometown, Russellville, Arkansas, age 35 years old. He was killed July 16, 2015. Yeah, Chattanooga, Tennessee. His unit was 4th Marine Division, Marine Forces Reserves, Chattanooga, Tennessee. Died in a terrorist attack on a Marine training facility in Chattanooga, Tennessee. We have a thing called Run for the Fallen here in Arkansas. Every military personnel that was killed is a mile marker on Highway 64. This is what they leave at those mile markers. There's a little ceremony at each one of them, and they honor the family and our own personal homegrown service member that gave their life for our country. I need somebody doing sandbox that will take this to the sandbox. Thank you, Heather, for taking that.
I'll be here.
Okay.